So you got your brand new AC500 CPU. You unpack it, you fit it together, you plug Ethernet cable in, connect power supply, flip the switch on, and realize that something is not right. CPU shows update message on a display and nothing else happening. I'm Yuri from PLC Center of Expertise here in Heidelberg. Let's figure out together what's going on here. First of all, there is nothing wrong with your CPU. The reason of this behavior is missing firmware. Or technically speaking, there is a factory default firmware, sole purpose of which is to ask you to load up-to-date firmware. Now, with that in mind, let's jump into Automation Builder and get that firmware updated. Okay, I have created an empty project which corresponds to the hardware we have. Now we go to CPU settings and set up gateway properly so we can connect to the device. Click Scan Network, and we can immediately see the hint of the action we have to perform on the CPU. Device type field, beside normal device designation, also contains string update at the end. Select the line with CPU we want to update, click OK, and then click on the gray circle close to the PLC pictogram. This way we have communication path set up. You may notice that gray circle turns red instead of green. That is an indication that something is not okay with the CPU. In our case, it's just a sign that CPU requires update. Next, we go to the version information tab, and here we see more specific information on what is going on with firmware versions. Please have a look on the current CPU firmware version. It's 3 and all the zeros to the end. From the factory, we have this sort of blank firmware loaded to the CPUs. On the other hand, required firmware versions are coming from installed version of Automation Builder. This way, when you start working with brand new CPU, you can be sure that it has newest possible firmware version. So what do we do to update? Well, it's pretty straightforward. Press update firmware button and let Automation Builder and CPU handle it by themselves. The process might take a while, and indication on the CPU itself will change according to the stage of the update process. Eventually, Automation Builder will give us a message that the process is over. And indeed, new firmware is loaded, and after CPU automatic reboot, it's going to be ready for normal operation. We scan network again, and this time we see that device type has changed to the normal one, without any update strings at the end. Select this updated device, click on the gray circle close to the PLC pictogram to set up communication path. This time, circle turns green, because everything is okay with the CPU. To check current versions of the CPU, we go to the version information tab again, and we see that current firmware versions match required firmware versions. CPU is ready to be used. And that's how you update firmware of out-of-the-box CPU. Keep automating and have a lovely day.